Hey everyone, it's Julie. Today I wanted to talk a little bit about what to eat when you get sick. First, a disclaimer here, I am not a doctor, so please seek advice from your doctor if you are sick. So we all know there's a virus circulating around at the moment, making people sick, and as well as just the common cold and other things that you're going to encounter on, you know, living a human life. But I wanted to talk a little bit about some things that I think are so important when it comes to getting sick and your diet. So the first thing is, it's so important before you get sick, and this is something you need to be kind of practicing on the daily, is to have a balanced blood sugar and not be contributing to metabolic syndrome in your body. Metabolic syndrome is obviously something that involves many different illnesses or diseases that you can get. Diabetes, obesity, all of these things pertain to metabolic syndrome. And so metabolic syndrome does have a lot to do with your blood sugar. I was under the impression that it was mostly omega-6 oils that could contribute to, you know, messing up your mitochondria, etc. But I've seen personally in people who have messed up blood sugar who are not eating a drop of omega-6 oils. I've seen this personally, and I actually wanted to point out this article that I spoke about in another video about pre-diabetes and lean vegans, because these lean vegans are not necessarily, I don't believe, eating a lot of omega-6 oils. I think this can happen to anyone who just keeps slamming their body with sugar. And perhaps it doesn't lead to actual diabetes, but I think it leads to blood sugar issues and possibly metabolic syndrome. So getting your blood sugar under control is going to involve not slamming it with carbs every single minute of the day, having protein and fat, and some people believe fiber as well, with your meals to slow down your blood sugar absorption. If you're just eating carbs all day, carbs, I do believe this can lead to blood sugar issues and potentially metabolic syndrome. And this is going to make things worse when you get sick. We all know that something that makes the current virus worse when you get it is if you have metabolic syndrome. It's going to exacerbate the symptoms and lead to worse outcomes. So it's so important that you get your blood sugar under control. Keeping it around 150 is a good level, 150 grams of carbs per day. Underneath is good too. 150, 200 is kind of where I hover, and I tend to be better at recovering from illnesses now compared to when I was like a high carb vegan. The second point is that I think maybe people don't think about when they get sick, but controlling for histamine foods when you're sick might help, since a lot of these illnesses create a histamine reaction in your body. And when that happens, it helps to not be dumping extra histamine into your body. So giving up fermented foods is definitely a good thing. Cured meats, cheeses, stuff like that, hard cheeses, yogurts, sauerkraut, any of that kind of stuff when you're sick could potentially exacerbate an illness that increases histamine reaction. There are other foods on that list, like beans, certain grains, some citrus fruit, stuff like that. I would say it could be beneficial to avoid these things when you're sick with something that exacerbates histamine. Another thing you can do about histamine is take kidney. Beef kidney has DAO in it, and DAO helps clear histamine from the body. So if you have some kidney, that could help balance out any histamine you do have in your body. And of course, we've heard about all these things to strengthen the immune system. Just getting your nutrients up to par is so important. And in my opinion, supplements are never going to be as effective as real food. So get your vitamin D foods, or your sun if you can at this time of year. Get your zinc. Your vitamin C is always good. Make sure your amino acids are up. Make sure your stocks are full, because if you get sick and you're unable to eat very much, you're gonna be relying on those stocks and you're gonna be burning your own fat. So that's another reason to get your blood sugar under control, because you wanna be fat adapted. You wanna be able to tap into those fat stores when you get sick. You don't want to get sick and all of a sudden realize that you're not fat adapted and you need carbs the whole time, because that's going to throw your blood sugar off even more. So hopefully this was helpful. I think these are things that you don't normally hear about when talking about illness. You know, you hear a lot about vitamin C and, I don't know, garlic and stuff like that. But these are things that maybe you could also think about, things that you could plan before you get sick, and then things that you can do once you are sick. So thanks for listening today, and I'll see you in another video.